Taste this!
Well, I hope you enjoyed that tour of the Greek Mediterranean restaurant. I'm going to get started on some recipes of my own today. Garofalo pasta. Now, jumping back over here to our next recipe that we're going to talk about today is going to be our pasta and scallop dish. Now, the good thing about, we're just going to actually switch fires here a second. The good thing about the scallop dish that I'm about to prepare today is it's made with a salmon spread. You can buy these salmon spreads already available in the store. This is a salmon spread right here. Some of them are really good, like Splendid Spreads, amazing. Okay. Now, I think it adds a great flavor. It really lends itself to the dish. We're going to add a little bit of olive oil here. This is a combination of olive oil and butter. So we're going to be adding the butter in here. You know, whenever you're making scallops, like as a sauce or anything like that, I always recommend that you definitely add butter. It really takes its flavor on to the next level. We have some bay scallops here we're going to put in the dish. Now, bay scallops are very similar to any scallop you might see out there, except they're smaller. Now, the thing about bay scallops is you can or cannot get away with sometimes the muscle that's attached to the scallop dish there. There's a little bit, you know, usually people kind of remove this. But you don't have to with the bay scallops. The sea scallops, you would definitely need to remove that. Now, our scallops get cooked in there, and bay scallops especially get cooked very quickly. You don't want to overcook the scallop. So what we're going to do is take a little bit of salt, some cracked black pepper, and give it a stir. Now what we're going to do is take our scallops and put them right back in our pot, because you don't want to cook anything. Return the pot, and this is a little technique I'm going to show you. Take the juice of the scallop, but leave the scallop still on the side because these are cooked perfectly. And add your onions. Now what you're going to do is you're going to sweat these onions out. Turn this fire up a little bit. These are looking good. Now you have the smell of the scallops, which is equally important. These onions are going to wilt, and when they wilt, we're going to add the rest of these ingredients here. This is really a great dish. If a lot of you remember, years ago, back in the early 80s, late 80s, there was a restaurant or a lot of dishes on the restaurant called Conquille St. Jack, which was scallops in a delicate velouté sauce put underneath a broiler, and then with a secret cream sauce that a lot of chefs used to make, you were able to get that nice brown sheen over the top of it. This is a variation to that. So that's why, you know, when you're cooking scallops, scallops need that butter. They need that fat. Now, you could go ahead and add basil to this dish. We talked about that before, that sometimes basil alters the flavor. In this case, I think it would help it. What we're going to do is simply take a little bit of basil pesto that I have here and just put it in there for flavor. I always have pestos in my kitchen. Sun-dried tomato, roasted red pepper, any, you name it, I have it. So what I'm going to do is just add a little bit of that. I'm going to get the flavor of the garlic. I'm going to get the flavor of a little bit of the peanut sauce. It's really not going to alter this that much. But I'm just going to spread this around. As you notice, what it does to the color here is really good. But what it does to the flavor is amazing. All right, now we're going to take a little bit of our pasta here, and we're going to put it in our pot. We're going to salt our water. All right, we salted our water. We're going to let our pasta come to a boil. Now what we're going to do over here is add just a little bit more of wine just to get all those flavors off from the bottom. And we are totally done with our onions. We're just going to kind of leave our onions off to the side here. Now we're going to take our pasta. Now pasta generally, spaghetti, I don't like to go more than 8 minutes over. Now we're going to get our pasta straining first before we do anything. Now pasta, I generally like al dente. For this particular dish, the only thing you have to make sure is that the pasta is strained. We're just going to leave that pasta kind of sitting there a little bit like that, drying up, because really the liquid that we want it to absorb is with the sauce that we're going to create. Now, we got these onions that we spoke about before, right? We said don't overcook them. You know, the butter might break. We didn't overcook the scallops here, which we're going to be putting back in here. So we're at a state here where it's very warm. We're not overcooking anything. Now, we put in our cooked salmon that we already have, our spread, right in there. And I'll show you how you mix this up. This is a dish right here. Mix it up gently. All right, next what you're going to do is take your pasta that you strained here and put it right down in the center. Get your dish or your bowl. I think I like a dish for this. I mean, it's not one of these things where it's going to be like a sloppy soup mess. You know, you need a whole loaf of bread to dip into. This is a pretty elegant, I think, dish. And take our pasta. You notice how it sticks together like that? That's what I'm talking about, because we didn't put any kind of cold water on the pasta. And we're just going to let it go right in the center. You got to do a little twisting. Go ahead. All right, now we're going to take all this great sauce that we created. You know, we spoke about the salmon. We spoke about the scallops and the onions. Now, that's what I'm talking about. This is really incredible pasta. Thank you for watching this edition of Taste This TV. I'm your host, Chef Joseph Ciminera. Remember, there are no rules in cooking. Taste this.